All right, time for our last speaker before the break. I'd like to introduce you to Enzo Rivello. And Enzo has only been working for Alfresco for 5 months. So if you haven't already had a chance to meet him and shower him in community goodness, you should probably do that so that you can get the true feel for what we're all about. But we're looking forward to hearing your talk on Alfresco SPK.
Hello? Perfect. Good. So, welcome to the Alfresco Software Provisioning Kit talk. I'm Enzo, as I said before, and I will be your speaker for the next 20 minutes. So, before starting, just a few words of who I am and what I did before and what I actually do in Alfresco. Right now, I enjoyed like 5 months working as Alfresco DevOps inside in a London team, and it was a roller coaster of emotion. In every kind of spectrum. And after 5 months, I'm helping developing and deploying software like Activity in future dev platform and collaborating with the tooling and automation team. Before, I worked 1 year for the DevOps at PlayStation Europe with a sister department in California. And right now, I'm the lead developer for the Alfresco SPK and the Vagrant Packer plugin. Please, if you want, follow our blog. I write there sometimes, I should write more. Or follow me on GitHub, or even if you want, follow me on Twitter. My Twitter is a private one. I keep it only for friends and family, but after 2 days with all of you, I consider you all as a friend, to be honest. So, what actually I do? I'm part of the tooling and automation team. We strive to automate all the things, and really, we try to do that very hard. And we found out that working with different team, that's different kind of problems, so we can't really find a single solution for everyone to work off. So we have to find one solution, flexible one, that actually adapts to everyone. So in this case, we start to automate technologies for all the departments, all across them. Then take the artifacts that all the team creates and integrate it into building system. And as you see from this building system, I work very closely with Samuel, our senior building engineer. And other than that, we do evangelization. This team is very young, like 1.5 months young, but I already started working on talking on SPK in YouTube with Oe last month. This talk now and next month in a DevOps meetup in London, which we're actually trying to export our way to do things. So let's go back to the main point of this presentation. Alfresco SPK, which is our tool to design, run, and integrate Alfresco stacks. So before this, anyone ever heard about Alfresco SPK here? Oh, more people than I was thinking. Did you ever play with it? Okay, third question, did you actually understood what it is? Because we did a fantastic job in actually advertising it, but not a great job in explaining what it is. So the first thing that I did was what the SPK does. And after a few hours of concentration, I found out that the perfect sentence to describe that would be, is a transposition engine to test your configuration locally and transform it to a different format, maybe backend boxes, AWS AMIs, maybe Docker containers, whatever. Is a transformation engine, but doesn't have anything to do with transformation service. That's why I say I use transposition. And if you're still confused about this, it's totally normal, because I didn't get into a technical description, and this is a technical audience, most of all. So really, what is it? The SPK is a collection of JSON files, JSON configuration file, along with Packer scripts, chef recipes, and background configuration. All in all, these technologies, they are tied up into one single component called the Vagrant Packer plugin. All of this is the SPK. It's a pure open source philosophy. We take something that already has been done, and we tie them up to do something totally new. So we did this like then The reason why we did this was for many, many reasons. The entire idea of the SPK was made by Maurizio Pillito, Mao, like 7-8 months ago. I think that the earliest blog post about the SPK was around November 2015, and it was the presentation of it. And it was made by his own experience in working with inside and out Alfresco as a consultant and with different companies. And while he worked, he found out two main challenges. The challenges were the hosting challenges, which it's taken all the kind of cloud providers, which is AWS, Rackspace, even not only that, but also private cloud, like VMware cluster inside cell companies. And taking all the orchestration tools that a lot of companies, especially the big one, are so fond to create one for themselves. And the name, for example, they got totally creative, like Orca from Orchestrator, which is a very, very creative name. Saying all of this, basically, all the hosting challenges, we need to find a specific solution or adaptable solution to all of them. But not only that, also for the provisioning challenges. Problems like distributed architecture or articulated provisioning process are something that we found out, especially solution engineers found out every day with their own work. And there's always a solution, but it's a very cranky one and very slow one. We try to actually help them out that. Plus, the Alfresco installer has a limitation, like it's monolithic architecture. If you need to work with your client and you need to create a different kind of environment or a different kind of distribution, you cannot do that on the spot. You can have to go back, ask another process to create another installer and feed them back. It's a little bit slow. So the solution we found out was a totally revamp of the Alfresco installation. Alfresco installation need to be customizable, modular, versionable, and portable. Customizable means that everyone, even our client, need to be able to change it, to modify it as much as they want. Modular means that maybe not your client will not need all the packages that we offer. Maybe you can find the best solution for them and to actually slim them down their own pipeline for deployment. For example, they probably don't need AOS or RM. Clients normally happens to don't want that. Needs to be versionable, means that all the kind of we need to be able to provide a stable version of this system, and provide also snapshots in which you can use the latest leading edge features. And finally, portable. It doesn't matter how you test your stack inside; it needs to be portable on every kind of cloud environment, even cloud, private cloud, or semi-private cloud. Let's talk about the Alfresco installation then, and how we envision it. As you can see here, we got an instance lifecycle as we envision. On the right side, it's a little bit of a typical slide. We start reading from the right, then to the left. The right, we got the final product, which is, in this case, is something like canonical Alfresco share installation. Two share repo plus two solar installation, all in all. But how do we arrive there? How do we provision that into the stack engine, which is the cloud provider? We do that in two ways. First of all, we can first create an image, upload that, and then bootstrap it in a second time, or do a full provisioning directly on the cloud from your machine or from the CI engine. Both of the approach have different kind of reason to exist. Full provisioning if you want to provide a quick solution, while you want to provide a more stable deployment pipeline. And we provide a solution with Chef Alfresco that cover all of these steps. We can create the AMI, we can bootstrap them when actually we need them, or we can create a different version of the same AMI to use that or to roll back then, or we can create automatically full provisioning on the stack, and we can update it at runtime whenever we want. The core of this, as I said before, is Chef Alfresco, which is a revamped Chef installer. As you can see, it's a cool logo, nice one. It's component-based in this case, means that repo, share, solar, OS, and all the are just component. You can mix and match, remove them to see as you see fit. Plus, we employ, it's not written here, but employ also HA proxy for load balancing and Nginx2 for providing HTTP2 pages. You support all the three run modes with creation, image creation, bootstrapping, and full provisioning. Any Alfresco configuration can be customized. I will show you shortly an example, but it's a very small one, but to give you just an insight of what can be done. It can run continuously. It means that if you create the final installation with the image or a full provisioning, if you point the chef runner there again, it will update itself and will update all the latest version as much as you want. And finally, it downloads an artifact instead of from Nexus or any kind of repository you want, instead of just the monolithic installation of Alfresco installer. It's currently open source. It has 70 releases and 11 contributors. So if you want to go and take a look, you're very, very welcome. And right now we talked about only the core of it actually work. But now we're talking about the Alfresco SPK, which is a two-man band. It's called by Alfresco SPK, which is a collection of libraries, collection of scripts, and the vagrant packer plugin, which is the one that ties all them up. With this two-man band, we tried to establish a workflow of activity. First of all, you choose a stack. You go into the Alfresco SPK repository, see how they are done, see actually what they do, get inspired, and modify, or even create your own one. Run locally your own stack, and see what at work. And if you are satisfied with that, go to build the image. If not, you still continue to tweak. But once that you have built the images, it is immutable images up across a different format. You can then integrate them into your own CI and orchestration tool. Maybe Jenkins, maybe Bamboo, everything you want. The SPK library, a little bit more in-depth here, is made by two different files. One is the instance template, which has all the Alfresco attributes that you need to inject inside the installation, with all the information about Packer and all the information for the local run. And a backend file that holds both the options and the config options for both of the run, both the creation of the immutable image or the local machine, plus the specific configuration for both backend and Packer. And we already provide a configuration for Alfresco, which is all-in-one and enterprise. And if you don't believe it, just go and try yourself. You go and clone an Alfresco SPK from master, install the Vagrant Packer plugin. You may even want to upgrade your Vagrant installation if you want. And then go inside the stacks, so community all in one, and then just Vagrant app to spin up a machine to an Alfresco installation in your machine, or Vagrant Packer build to create a Vagrant box in this case. Now it's demo time. And in this case, I thought about doing it live, but it was taking like 44 minutes to create an entire stack with this kind of network. So I did it, and I recorded it. So this is a pristine installation of Alfresco SPK. I go inside the community all-in-one folder. And just see there is a Vagrant file, and I run Vagrant app. And automatically, it starts an entire system, and little by little, will start also the chef installer, download all the cookbooks, and chef installer to download the recipes. And all in all, this is the final product. Files. Let's try to upload some. And it works. It works as intended. Now, I don't want to give a very in-depth view of what is the configuration. I was trying actually to understand, let you understand what this configuration is made of. I say the SPK is made mostly by two parts, which is the instance template, which is this. Can you see it? This is all the Alfresco installation options. you can define all the components just by inserting into an array. The start service, in this case, is false because when I create a build image, if I start a service, a packer will complain and will not finish correctly, in which public I want to export the SSL. This is the run list that will be run inside the chef. And this is all the information about packer, which provisioner to use, which builder to use, and which post-processor to use. In this case, it will be as a provisioner chef. It will use the VirtualBox engine to actually build the mutable image, and as a post-processor, it will export a Vagrant box file. And finally, all the other information that we get Vagrant can use, or in this case, in other case, or AWS can use, like secret ID or secret access key. And finally, the information for the local run. In this case, it has been launched on 192.168.3.3.4.3. This is one part. The Vagrant file is the one that tied up both of the part, both the creation of the image and the local run. The packer build, this is all the configuration you needed to run with packer, which will always reference the community all-in-one. In this case, the instance template we already saw. And this is all the configuration needed to work with the local installation. As you see, I even override them, some of them. I removed the transformation because it was too heavy for this demo to actually test it out. So we can actually test it out and create your own stack as much as you want. And well, that's pretty much it. Let's do a quick wrapping up. So with Alfresco SPK, we want to actually try to export even not only a useful tool for you to use, but also an entire workflow or best kind of practice that possible will help out all the team achieving the same result in the faster way. First of all, you got a configuration, you choose an SPK stack, play with the background file, get inspired, and create your own. Then you test your stack, see if you are okay, then export it somewhere, and then you have your own cloud of choice, and then you finally insert inside your own orchestration tools and CI. This is thanks to the chef that provides a configuration as infrastructure as a code, and SPK that ties all of this up and creates lazy immutable images. One good thing is that we already using SPK inside Alfresco. The AWS Marketplace MI is already done, the file one enterprise only one. And this morning, I pushed the request for review for the enterprise all-in-one and records management. It has already been done with SPK. The online trials are made then and already updated a couple of times with SPK. And the Alfresco AWS CloudFormation template, the MI, is made with SPK, and we are testing it out thanks to Tony. All the others are still a work in progress, but we are getting there. This is a roadmap, and we would like to get there as soon as we can. There's a support for additional Linux, Unix, OSS. There's to publish Alfresco backend boxes for existing instance templates. There is the possibility of integration with Docker. However, it's a little bit very uncertain question, because the images created with SPK don't have a backend file, because they are directly created using the packer with the engine. So they may be used internally, but if we want to work with the community, they will be a little bit obscure for you to understand. We may go with the trusted images later, once we found out how actually to integrate the trusted images with Chef. But this is something that we are going to work with. Integrate with Alfresco SDK. Now I'm working tight closed with the developer platform team in London and Ohio, so expect a tight integration later. And improve docs for advanced Chef users if you're interested. And finally, publish a Chef Alfresco into the main repository, which is a Chef Supermarket. But we really wanted only one thing to make this project awesome, and this is you. Because this was a community project made by a community here, which was Maurizio, and it was made thanks to you and listening to your feedback. So please, if you have anything, if you have any reason or any suggestion to do that, we are here for you. For now, for example, we use only Chef Alfresco because that's what we use best. But we will be happy, for example, to integrate Ansible or integrate even Puppet if possible. If this is possible, we'll try to make it real. But if we make it real and awesome, thanks to you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Any? There are any questions?
Any questions for Enzo? No. We'll get it on the recording. So.
Thank you, Enzo, first of all, for the presentation.
Thanks to you.
And welcome. just one question. During the example, you show the only one and enterprise compliance. Do you plan, or is it compliance also with the community edition? Because in the example too, I see a community all-in-one that I don't understand from an Alfresco point of view.
This is just a community all-in-one that I made for testing. But we made some other experiment about creating different instances with different purposes that could talk with them together. Like one machine only with share and repo, and the other one only with solar, so to talk to them together.
But only for the enterprise edition or also for the community edition?
Also for the beginning with the community edition, but then we will work out with enterprise. There is a branch in there that's called the new Tomcat, and which will be the next best thing in Chef Alfresco that already take care of that.
Now, do you know why I'm asking that question? Because I personally appreciate what you say. Please contribute, please use, please tell me how to do AVSAM. Of course, for this audience, but I think it's very important to be clear if this is only for enterprise, both, but Tony's answering me and you answer very clearly, this for both. So
it will be
we
for
all
it will be
can
for both.
Contribute also for other
it will be
so
for both.
For
it cannot
that.
Be closed only for enterprise anyway.
It's very good for community as well, because you can build an image only for share and also another image for the repo, and to leave MySQL out because you want to use your own MySQL or RDS or whatever you need in the cloud, for example. So it's very good to build any assets that you need, even for community or for enterprise. The difference, of course, in the enterprise when you are using SPK is that you can pre-configure the cluster. This is the only difference at the end of the day, and some libraries. But other than that, you can use it for both.
Don't want to talk only me, but another question. I make this question to Maurizio, director in Rome, in Alfresco Day. I answered to him, it was together with Gabriele Columbro, and I asked them how this could be related with the previous presentation and the nice application that we have with the Honeycomb. Because from a certain point of view, I feel a intersection between them. But I think that we all have to find one solution, not two, or a competition inside. But don't want to talk about the competition, but a thought could be how to relate this with the Honeycomb and so on.
Actually, this is an excellent question. The fact is, in the what SPK does is mostly build and test your own stack. Okay. Right now, he's using Chef, not using Puppet, sorry, but he's using Chef. But this doesn't mean anything. SPK by itself is an engine that, in theory, should be totally agnostic. It should be able to use Chef as you'd be able to use Puppet as well. And if it is not now reality, it will be reality, especially if you guys can give a help. I don't know a lot about Puppet. I know that share the same kind of language like Ruby. I know that. But I will be glad to help you out and actually get this as a one single project. But I can do that, or you can use your Chef for Honeycomb.
So this is awesome. Thank you so much for presenting. So I went to GitHub and I downloaded this project and I tried the couple of commands and it didn't work. And it didn't work. Well, that was challenging. Okay, so I have to go look in the files and, there's these two files, but actually then there's a bunch of other files, related to Chef and Chef Alfresco and the documentation. There's like all of these config values that don't, at least 2 months ago, there wasn't much documentation. So, you know, I'm reasonably familiar with Vagrant, but not with Packer or, you know, some of the other technologies, Chef, that you guys are using. What can be done to improve the documentation for people who are coming to this relatively new?
That is in the roadmap. Thank you for the question, but this is a roadmap about making advanced documentation for people who are coming. Right now, we are working very hard about getting all this kind of information into one single part and making maybe even interactive for people to understand all how these different technologies work together. So yeah, it's a very good feedback, and we will work very hard on that.
Cool. Thanks, Enzo.
Thank you very much.